Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, we are going to talk everything that you need to know about Cryptanthus. Now, Cryptanthus are a species which belongs to the family Bromeliaceae. You must be knowing bromeliad, so this is the family which is the same as that. But these are also known as earth stars. And these have some beautiful shades and colors. Now you can see this tray right here. Now this one, you can see there are pinks, greens, reds, browns, everything. They are plants which look beautiful with flowers as well as only their foliage. This is the plant which belongs to the same family as that of the pineapple. Now here you can see I have the pineapple, which is the ornamental one, right here with me. Sorry, it's too heavy to carry, so I have to keep it back. But yeah, so that's the ornamental pineapple that I have, which belongs to the same family as that of this Cryptanthus. Now, what we need to know if we want to grow Cryptanthus? These are plants which do not like to be kept in direct sunlight because they either burn or fade out. So you have to give them indirect or medium bright light. These are plants which are endemic to Brazil, and you'll mostly find these in the forest in tropical areas under the canopy of trees. And they're not usually very deep rooted. That is why it requires a potting mix which is very well draining and very light. It does not do really well when you are giving it a tight fitting soil. For example, I will show you here. I have one which is in direct soil, but I haven't seen much growth or any improvement in this one. But the ones which I have here, you can see it does not really have any kind of soil. So what I have in this is basically just pieces of charcoal, some terracotta pieces. You can even add some brick pieces in it. You can add, to retain the moisture, you can add some coconut coir or coconut husk, and that's it. It will do well. Now, to provide some kind of nutrition to it, and if you want it to propagate, what you can do is add a little Epsom salt and water and add that to it, so that helps in getting some kind of magnesium and sulfur, which is good for the plants to grow. This tray of mine is been sitting in an area which is well shadowed with all the other plants, but it gets ample amount of humidity and bright light. But I wouldn't say direct sunlight, because I tried keeping them in direct sunlight and all I had were just green leaves. And these are plants which have varied colors and patterns, and you do not want to destroy them by keeping it in direct sunlight. A few months back, I had ordered a few Cryptanthus which arrived just 2 days back. So I have it with me right now. And we are going to pot them up now, and I will tell you what exactly I have used in the potting mix. So the first one that we have here is Cryptanthus acaulis variegata. You can see how beautiful the color on this leaves is. It came up wrapped up in this sphagnum moss here. And what we are working with is this. That's the root system. It looks quite okay and will do well once we have potted them up. These are the brown leaves that I'm going to take off. The second one we have here is Cryptanthus vivitatus. Cryptanthus vivitatus red star. That's the root system, if you can see. Okay. The third one we have is the lesser day meniscus or meniscal. That's what it's called. So we are going to be potting up in this cement mixing tray that I have, which is actually, it had a crack, so I stitched it up and now I'm going to use this, and I just painted it a solid color, which I usually do if you know me. This is going to be the potting mix. Now what we have over here is charcoal, terracotta pieces. Wait, let me show you. There's some charcoal chunks, terracotta pieces. Then I have added some stones. And I have over here, that's a coconut husk. This is what I'm going to use to pot these beauties up. I'm just going to transfer this. This is well filled up. Now what we have to do, it just take these and push them down, make a hole and push them down there. So there you go. I'm just using moss because moss is something which provides more amount of moisture and humidity, which these plants love. There you go. The last thing we got to do is water them. So what I've done in the water is I have mixed some Epsom salt, which is hydrated magnesium sulfate. So I'm going to put this around in the whole tray because this will help the plants to grow and propagate. One of the reasons why these plants, they love being in a potting mix which provides a lot of aeration, is that it helps them propagate. Whereas if you provide them with something which is a very compact potting mix, it will not help the babies to pop up. And that, I don't think we want that. We love plants which propagate and show us some growth. So here we have a Cryptanthus nicely potted up and looking pretty. So I hope you enjoyed the whole process and understood a few important things about Cryptanthus. Now there are a lot of other varieties, such as you might have heard about air plants. They also belong to the family of bromeliads, but their care is a little different than these. There are some which do quite well when you provide them with soil. For example, the pineapple behind me, that does really well when it's given soil. But these ones I have experimented. I know that they do quite well when they are given such kind of potting mix. And if you give them a very compact potting mix, they will survive, but I wouldn't say they would thrive. That's all for today's video. I hope you enjoyed it. Do let me know in the comments below what you think of videos like this. And if you own a Cryptanthus, do let me know what are your care tips. Do not forget to subscribe, like and share this video. Hoping to see you soon in the next video. Until then, bye-bye.